Outrage and sorrow surrounded the death of Ugandan Olympian Rebecca Cheptegei, who succumbed to severe burns after being dosed with petrol and set on fire by her boyfriend at her home in Kenya. The 33-year-old Ugandan marathon runner who competed in the recent Paris Olympics was targeted on Sunday after returning home from church with her two daughters, according to authorities in northwest Kenya, where Cheptegei lived and trained. Cheptegei is said to have bought a plot in Trans Nzoia County and built a house to be near Kenya's elite athletics training centers. A report filed by a local administrator alleged that the athlete and her partner Dickson Diema Marangach had been in wrangles over the piece of land. Kenya police say an investigation is currently underway. Marangach allegedly snuck into her home while she was at church. He also received severe burns in the incident. Kimani Mbugua, the head of intensive unit at the Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital, said he was in stable condition but still in intensive care.
And today it is my sad duty to inform you of the passing of Rebecca Cheptegei, who was admitted in our unit following severe burns that she sustained. So during the course of her stay here, we've done all that we could for her. She had a severe percentage of burns, which unfortunately led to multi-organ failure, which ultimately led to her passing this morning at 5:30 a.m.
This is the latest public act of gender-based violence in the East African country, where activists have warned of a rising femicide epidemic. Njeri Mwigwi, the founder of Osikimie, an organization that fights gender-based violence, wants immediate action.
This is the fourth murder in a series of murder from 2021 for female athletes. But this is also another, I will not call it murder, I will call it femicide, because femicide is the intentional murdering of women due to their gender, and also intimate femicide, which is what happened in this case, where she was murdered because they had a quarrel about land that she built on. And if you look at the intentionality of the murders between all these athletes who have been murdered by their husbands, boyfriends or partners, if you look at it, there is a thread of finances, the fact that these women have been able to be on the prime of their life, been able to amass wealth, and this wealth unfortunately has led to their death.
Kenyan media said Cheptegei's children, aged 9 and 11, witnessed the attack, which took place just weeks after she made her Olympic debut in the women's marathon, where she finished 44th. The First Lady and Minister of Education and Sports, Mrs. Janet Museveni, said she was deeply saddened by Cheptegei's tragic death, according to a post on X. This death has also seen some Ugandans calling for support and protection of the athletes.
Yeah, we've really made the big loss. Rebecca would be a very big inspiration to many young Olympics coming in. In Uganda, we are trying to build up the Olympics. So when we are building up this and we are losing the same people, then it is a disservice to us.
I think this is very bad. And I think the government of Uganda should see to it and see how these people can be protected, because they're raising our flag high.
Even though that boyfriend is in their country, the Ugandans, all we as Ugandans, we have to raise a voice. And even that person, because he's below the law, you understand, that person has to be acted on how the law it has to be. Because no person, even though it wasn't a Ugandan, even though it was someone from another country, that wouldn't have been good. Because trust me, we are all human beings. And trust me, each and every person has a right to stay. Each and every person has a right to be alive, understand? Because there are very many girls that are inspired on how the lady she was.
Violence against women is widespread in Kenya, which saw 725 femicide cases in 2022 alone, according to the latest UN figures. A 2023 report by Kenya's National Bureau of Statistics found 34% of women had experienced physical violence since the age of 15. In October 2021, record-breaking Kenyan runner Agnes Chirop, 25, was found stabbed to death at her home in renowned Rift Valley, running up of Eden. In April 2022, Kenyan-born Berrian athlete Damaris Mutua was also found dead in Eton in a suspected domestic violence incident.